presentation. It's the most daring, death-defying escapes ever. Stay tuned for David Copperfield, The Great Escapes, CBS Next.
I guess you could say that every act of magic is an escape. An escape from the laws of nature. An escape from the real world. I'm David Copperfield. Some people call me an escape artist. Over the years, I've disappeared and reappeared tens of thousands of times. Some of my favorite moments have been the most dangerous. I mean, really dangerous.
In one of the most dangerous escapes of modern times, magician David Copperfield plans to...
Ace illusionist David Copperfield is risking it all again, this time over a bed of burning spikes.
In a race against time that has the authorities nervous...
Copperfield plans to escape from the imploding building in front of a live audience.
Copperfield will cheat death one more time as he tries to escape the roaring vacuum of Niagara Falls.
For the next hour, I'll relive some of those moments, and I'll give you an inside look at each escape as it's happening. So here we go. The Great Escapes. Escape. To get free of confinement or control. Houdini, for years, had escaped from a straitjacket, hanging upside down. For publicity, before every show, he'd get a crane and hang over the... in front of the building, outside the theater. And we decided to take it a few steps further. We started to burn the rope that I was hanging from, added spikes underneath me. The spikes would be on fire. We had more than one rope to burn through, so one by one, it created a great amount of drama and difficulty through it. And it was for a goal, to get the girl at the end. This was the first escape we did in front of tens of thousands of people. So the adrenaline was really high. It was like doing a rock concert, you know, a death-defying rock concert. I wanted it to be more than just a straitjacket, so we wrapped these straps around my arms to keep my arms really tightly in each sleeve. Looked good, felt bad. We got a bunch of football players and dressed them up as Amazonians. I wanted those guys to be really rough. I wanted them to really put me in to get that on camera. The purpose of a straitjacket was to hold the criminally insane, to stop them from hurting themselves. So it was a perfect fit. They lie me down, and I knew there was no turning back. When they were lighting those torches, you could feel the heat all around you. The intensity of the heat, the smell of the gasoline and the ropes burning, is really overwhelming. Put spikes underneath me, flaming spikes. So if I fall, I get shish kebabbed, or Dave kebabbed. When I looked down, the thought crossed my mind that if something went wrong, that's not the way I wanted to die. Hanging upside down, of course, is a different experience. The blood rushes to your head. It feels different. It feels, you feel your heartbeat. And you really have to get used to it. As I'm escaping, you can hear me yelling all through it, and it's real. You know, at that time, at that moment, I'm just trying to get out of there as quickly as I possibly can. I could see were those spikes on fire, which I never saw before in any of the rehearsals. For this escape, every night, after every show for a year, I took the entire audience outside the theater, and I did it. I would hang upside down from a crane, and every day we added more fire to the rope. It was like preparing for the marathon. For the months prior and all those rehearsals, I knew what it felt like to have the ropes break. But when we did it the final time, with spikes beneath me, and it was a whole other story. I really enjoy doing things if there's a point to it, doing things once. I don't ever have to do that fires of passion thing again. Never have to, which makes me very happy. But I wasn't scared getting into it or doing it because there was a point to it. It's going to be for a purpose. So there's a method behind stupidity, I think. You know, there's at least a goal behind it.
Coming up next, the building implosion.
It wasn't just my life in danger. There were 12 other people inside that building, you know. And when you have 12 other people, you feel responsible.
David Copperfield, The Great Escapes, is sponsored by The Clorox Company, dedicated to making great products for your home.
Hard to believe Daddy's gonna be 70.
Well, he looks good.
Must be all that clean living.
Yeah, right.
70. Think about all he's seen. Mm.
He's never seen Walt Disney World.
This year, come celebrate milestones together at a year-long millennium celebration your family will never forget. Just call 1-407-W-DISNEY.
Well, young blood, now I've seen everything.
But I haven't. Come on.
I will never let this container out of my sight. Uh-huh. I will care for it as if it were my own child.
A little overprotective of your Tupperware? Get Gladware, reusable containers that cost about 50 cents each. So if they lose them, don't get mad. Get Glad.
We combined power and intelligence and created a way to clean your pipes like they've never been cleaned before. Liquid Plumber, foaming pipe snake clog remover.
CBS Thursday. Imagine being in a coma for 15 years. What happens when you wake up?
This is a miracle.
Kathy Baker stars, and James Garner turned Chicago Hope into an HMO hospital.
Oh, having a heart attack.
Now he's getting a dose of his own medicine.
This is a mistake.
Don't miss an all-new Chicago Hope, CBS Thursday. What started as an infestation is now a full-blown invasion.
We've got a 250,000 angry bees in here.
And there's nowhere to hide. All new Now and Again, CBS Friday.
Perfect. Complete. Having all its essential qualities. Faultless. Excellent. Exact. Precise. A lot of people ask me if I'm a perfectionist. A lot of people ask me, you know, if I'm a control freak. And it's kind of a negative thing, a perfectionist, but
to make things work a certain way, whether you're a film director or whether you're an artist or whether you're a musician or a magician, illusionist, there has to be a level of perfection to make things work. To create the feeling of wonder, you have to have perfection with the technical stuff. And then you have to have a good time after that.
Here was the plan. I was handcuffed, locked inside a safe. The safe's got chains around it. The safe's inside a building, and the building is going to explode, actually implode. I had 2.5 minutes to get from the building to the platform with the X. This was really unique because it wasn't just my life in danger. There were 12 other people inside that building. Not only are you going to die if something goes wrong, they could die too. So when you see them running out of the building very fast, they mean it. It was important that the viewer felt like they were there. So we did one long camera shot, and we found this amazing camera operator who does all the Scorsese movies, Larry McConkie. And him and his brother would run out of the building and keep it without a cut. Make it one continuous move. From the moment I went to the safe, getting out of the building, going from one camera crane to another, holding the building in frame, watching the building implode until I finally made my escape. Every escape has its own set of rules. A lot of them you can do again, unless you die. But it's not true of the building. It's a one-shot deal. So the risk of failure is greater, and it makes it a lot more exciting. Watch these guys put the lock on the safe. It's about a 6-inch mistake. If that lock was only closer to the door, that would have saved me a good amount of time. Timer set. These walls that you're looking at right now, remember, won't be there in a second. Keep your eye on the remote control camera. You can follow my actions the entire time. Control camera pushes into the safe. We wanted to show the movement of the tumblers. When you turn tumblers inside a safe, or even outside a safe, you listen for clicks, you listen for the sounds to be right, and the feeling in your fingers. But inside the safe itself, my breathing overshadowed the sound of the tumblers. Tumblers are moving. The remote control camera pans to the wheel, and you see it turning.
Wind up the remote camera. 1 minute into detonation.
But the lock isn't in place.
50 seconds into detonation.
So I have to pull the chain to get to the lock. And pull the lock inside so I can work on it. The safe is small, really small. So I was really crunched up in there.
Six, five, four, three, two, one.
When I finally appeared, and people were applauding and slapping the five, the only thing that's going through my head is, I hope we got it all on camera. In the planning stages, we had a big problem, a big challenge. We wanted the finish line to be in a parking lot to the left of the building, and they denied us permission. It was a good thing that they said no, because when the building imploded, the entire dust of the building, the full, thick, black dust, was swept by the wind over the original parking lot that we asked for, which means we would have had no shot. If we'd gotten permission to use that lot, I would have been covered in dirt, the camera lens wouldn't have been able to see anything, it would have been covered with dirt, and it would have been a mess. Nothing would have worked. When you're doing an escape, after you go through that much effort, you want people at home to appreciate all the work that you've done. So you have to not only think about how to get out, but how to have the audience see it properly, get the real message. So there's two challenges. One is life-threatening, and the other is career-threatening.
Coming up next, Escape from Alcatraz.
Alcatraz was the home of the greatest escape artists who have ever lived, but none of them ever escaped. And some died trying.
Smothered with hot melted cheese. That's a lot of meat for national television. Got the urge?
Whoa, what was in this trash can?
Johnny made a mess in the bathroom.
Hey, cool. I'm stuck to the floor.
New Clorox disinfecting wipes. It's from Clorox, so it's more than clean.
Know the difference between bargain bleach and new dry Clorox bleach? Spill dry Clorox bleach, just brush it away. Spill bargain bleach, and you may throw it away. New dry Clorox bleach, fabric safe if spilled, whitens whites like Clorox bleach.
My motto is, the customer is always right. The problem was...
Pack of smokes?
Kids would try to buy cigarettes.
You got an ID for those smokes?
Oh, come on!
It's illegal for me to sell them to anyone under 18.
But since this weak hard program started, there's no argument. I just point to the sign.
We're committed to keeping cigarettes out of kids' hands. That's why Philip Morris is a major sponsor of the weak hard program.
I'm not alone when I say no, and that's a big help.
Working to make a difference, the people of Philip Morris.
Once there was a princess whose love for butter was doomed by wicked cholesterol. No one could wake her until...
I can't believe it's not butter.
I can't believe it's not butter!
The taste you love without the cholesterol.
I hear you can make really good pork chops with chicken bake.
Really?
Oh, really?
Moo!
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 Delicious pork chops from Shake and Bake Coating Mix.
When other trash bags break, don't get mad. Get glad. They're twice as thick as other trash bags.
Hollywood's going country.
Join Dixie Chicks,
Faith Hill,
and many more.
Dolly Parton hosts the Academy of Country Music Awards live CBS next Wednesday.
16 real castaways, 39 days, $1 million. On this island, there are no lifelines. Survivor, coming to CBS May 31st.
Hey, you want to make a difference and make new friends?
Me?
Try volunteering.
Are you into it?
Call 4-H or check out our website at areyouintoit.com.
My job is to make magic very vital. To give it as many emotional elements as music has, as dance has, as movies give the audience. I think the audience likes to see a human being under real situations having to kind of use his wits to get out of them. I think they enjoy that process. We've done it in a dramatic way. We've done it in an overly stagey way sometimes. Sometimes we do it really real. And they've stuck with me through the good and the bad, which is unbelievable. I've been very lucky. Alcatraz was the home of the greatest escape artists to have ever lived. Al Capone was there, Machine Gun Kelly. None of them ever escaped. Some died trying. That island is an amazing, amazing island. It has kind of a majesty about it. Yeah, they call it the Rock, and you can see why. This was set up to be a series of escapes, a series of challenges, from the cell, past guard dogs, to the holding area, and completely off the island. We invited a committee of former correctional officers who used to work there. You know, their job is to make sure everything was escape-proof, everything was accurate. They verified the cell was in place, the bars were still strong, there was nothing weird or funny going on. To make it a little bit more interesting, we had the UC Berkeley bomb squad set timed explosives in three separate areas. One inside the cell, one inside the cutoff area, the locked cutoff area, and one inside the last area that I have to get through to get out. Fake movie bombs? No, real bombs. Each of our bombs had little stop buttons on them. So if I got into trouble, I could hit the stop button and they would be disarmed. In Alcatraz, we couldn't have audience with explosives. We couldn't have audience in the prison itself. So we had remote control cameras all over the prison. And I actually performed each escape for those individual remote control cameras. It was a different approach. First, I'd be secured in a straitjacket in a cell. Start the timers.
3 minutes to first detonation.
Time is extremely important, and I'd rehearse every night in the show, actually, escaping from the straitjacket, to a specific time so I beat the bomb. And I'd focus on something. I'd always try to keep my energy and focus on one thing. In a theater, the only thing that's lit when you look into a back of an empty theater is an exit sign. And maybe it was some kind of a psychological assist, you know, seeing this, the word exit, the idea of exiting from the straitjacket, perhaps was psychologically helpful to me. And when I was in the cell in Alcatraz, the timing was off. We finally figured out that I didn't have something to look at. I wasn't focusing on the same thing. There are no exit signs in Alcatraz. The cell is 5 by 7 by 9, pretty small. The walls are 8-inch concrete, so the best way to get through is to get through the bars. So I used a little bit of an illusionary ability. Control cameras everywhere, and people outside watching the escape step by step through these remote control cameras. Guard dogs patrolling the area. So what do you do? How do you get past guard dogs? As an illusionist, you have to try to find a solution, and these are really mean dogs. These are not happy dogs at all, you know. But dogs like food, and they like cats. Probably more than me. So watch closely.
1 minute to second detonation.
Inspired by the movies that were out at the time, Indiana Jones, the multi-level challenges.
10 seconds.
Very, very expensive home movie with guard dogs. 5, 4, 3, 2. And explosives.
Detonation.
Obstacles were guarded by the guards, living human beings.
Just stand there next to the bomb.
I knew that if I didn't touch that button and I waited long enough, they'd come in and get me. So I had to get them to open the door for me. And the object was to challenge them to open the door, to come in, to try to save me from the last bomb. I sat there next to a bomb ready to go off, and they thought I was crazy.
Get in there. 5, 4, 3, 2, explosive, disarmed.
The last area was a storage room, which provided many opportunities. There was a box that I could use, and tables, and cabinets, many different items there that an illusionist or an escape artist could use to not only taunt the guards to come in, but to use it as illusionary devices to make my escape. And the last sequence, from when I get into the box till I make my escape at the end, is all one continuous tick. You can see all around the table, all around the box, people are watching in every direction. The box begins to explode. Underneath the table. You can have the guard walk through it. The camera never cuts.
Get to the helicopter! Get the camera up into the helicopter! Get the camera in the helicopter!
Watch those guards closely. So cute. You know, they say, keep your friends close and keep your enemies closer. Well, to get out, I became one of them.
Next, Niagara Falls.
I was in my hotel room and I had this nightmare. I died going over Niagara Falls.